Welcome, welcome, my beautiful Aquarius. Brenda here, Brenda Tarot, and I'm here again today to bring you your general tarot and oracle card forecast for the week of February the 7th to the 13th, 2022. Keep in mind, as I said, not every card or the energy they carry may resonate with every single one of you, but take what you can from it, throw the rest out into the universe to those that it does. If you require a private reading with me this week, I will be taking, I still have a couple of openings for this weekend, but short of that, I'm booking already up into next week. So all that information is always posted below every single one of my videos in the information box, my prices, and how to contact me via email. So on that note, let's see, Aquarius, what we have for your week. Starting off with your first energy card in the first row, you've been given Universe. We're all just stardust. So basically this says to look at the big picture and put balance back into your life. And you know what? It says here in this book, and I'm reading it today because this is a card I haven't had yet. When we're children, we can barely comprehend the vastness of our own lives, let alone the existence of other planets. It's not long before we learn we aren't the center of the universe. We are but specks of stardust in one of its many skies. However, we must all still do our part to take care of our own individual worlds, or else it throws everything else off balance. Make sure to keep balance in your personal life, but don't forget the big picture stuff. Recycle, don't litter, give thanks. Okay, so I think the main, you know, the main representation and meaning of this card is basically to be grateful for what we have, right? And also to show respect for what we do have and not go out there and take advantage of it. So I do think that you're going to be doing things that are right for you this week. You're going to be doing things that are right for other people this week as well. Spreading your stardust out there into the universe, because what we throw out into the universe, we receive back tenfold. So keep it positive, my beautiful Aquarians. Throw all that stardust of good luck and energy, respect and gratitude out into the universe this week, because I think this week you may be feeling this. All right, coming in with your first tarot card here, and we do have another card coming in with it, as you know, you've been given the Three of Wands. So basically, this is a card of wonderful karma, wonderful good energy, and you're working hard towards your goals here. Beautiful. You know, congratulations are in order here. You need to commend yourself for what you are doing, the good that you're doing, what you're throwing out into the universe, the work and determination that you're applying to and focusing on with your goals. So beautiful. It's also a time that says, you know, keep moving, keep going forward. You've completed something here, and you're waiting to see how it's going to come in, but step back and look at everything that you've done and review it, because you are creating a blueprint for your legacy, for your future. So just be patient if you're waiting. If you put something out there like a proposal or an idea, or you know, you've worked on a contract that you've completed and you're waiting to hear how it's been received. But I do think that, you know, patience is required when success is on the horizon for you. You could be taking on a new or an important job at this time. While you finish this one, you could be going on to the next one. You could also be looking towards your future here and having to plan a business trip. But others could be seeking out wise counsel to guide you through this process. You could be discussing things with other people here, the powers that be. Coming in next, you have the Star. Yeah, wish upon a star, my beautiful Aquarius, because you are the star. You're showcasing yourself. You're letting the universe and everybody know what you're made of and what you've got and what you can offer to everybody. So go ahead and wish upon this star. You've got every reason to feel hope and happy expectation, and believe in yourself. Believe in your dreams. Be optimistic here, okay? And be excited. And, you know, any challenges now are behind you, and things are going to be brighter for you. I think you're, you know, like I said, starting off, throwing that star and optimism and positivity out into the universe is definitely coming back tenfold. So this is beautiful. Trust and follow your intuition, because I'm telling you, it's right on target. This is a prosperous new beginning for some of you, okay? Know that you're on the right path. Your next row here, you've got let go. Well, you can't be any more open than that. What, if anything, can be done to let go of what is standing in your way? If anything, what? If anything can be done to let go of what is standing in your way? Well, I don't think so. I think what we've got here is you letting things go that are no longer serving you. That's what this is about. Let go and let God. You're dealing with things here, right? I'm going to take this number. 5 and 3 is 8. 8 is the number we work on when we're working on money or we're manifesting money in our lives. So this could be something to do with a financial thing for some of you. But let go, okay? If you don't push things, don't allow things to stand in your way, but you need to go with the flow here, okay? Let go of what is standing in your way. And sometimes it's ourselves. We hold ourselves, we have to hold ourselves accountable. We're in our own way. We have to let things go. Letting others become responsible for themselves and saying goodbye is never easy, but sometimes it's necessary and inevitable to let people go from our lives as well. We can't allow that grip, that tug, as I've been saying to everybody, pull us and hold us back from going towards our goal. So you could be parting ways here with somebody. Now, you've got the Five of Cups, which is thinking about the past, reminiscing about it, being nostalgic, but also crying over it, crying over spilt milk, thinking about maybe the regrets and the what ifs and things might not have been successful in the past with a situation or a person. But you need to realize that your cups are going to fill again. And as we say, you have to look for the prize still here. There's still more out there. There's more fish in the sea. You've got to wipe up the spilt milk and go forward because allow and let it go, right? Because if you don't, it's going to hold you hostage in this position so that you can't move forward with optimism, with you know, confidence to go towards a new future here. Look what you have. You had the Three of Wands, and now you have the Three of Wands again. So definitely you're going to see success on the horizon. You're going to be, going forward in a new direction, and you're ready now to step up, get those rewards for the hard work and effort that you struggled with here and the decisions that you made to go forward. Basically, that's what you're doing here. Now, in your center position, you do have the Shark card. Take care. There will be a loss of material wealth. So if you're not careful with your money and you're not aware of where it's going and how it's being spent or how it's being invested or how you're the extremes in which you're spending it or saving it, this could happen. So there could also be somebody around you that wants something from you. There could be somebody that, you know, let's call them a loan shark, right? Beware of someone who offers you something that sounds too good to be true. Investing your money into something that could bring loss. That's what they're telling me. But also beware of someone who could be wanting something from you and then they have no intention of making a promissory note and keeping their word. So be careful of that. It may require strength here to stand up to somebody that's constantly hounding you for something, or standing up to someone, the powers that be, that could be inflicting that energy on you this week. I think, you know, the best thing to do is just smile and walk away from it, because this is a card that says don't go in there with the roar of the lion, because it's only going to frustrate you. Go in there, you know, walk away from it, say not interested, I'm out of here, and then you don't have to deal with it at all. You've got the Sun, and that means, yeah, wow, you had the Star, now you have the Sun. I always call the Sun the best card in the deck. That's me as a personal reader. Others use other cards. But I do believe that the Sun is shining down on you, and you're going to have people in your end of the ring that will support you as you move forward through your struggles and also through your successes here. And that's what's important, to have that energy in your end of the ring. So it's a beautiful card that says, be ready. Be ready to accept all the good that's coming into you. You're going to be getting recognized for something that you're pulling off here, and that's beautiful. And it could be public recognition. Maybe you're building up your clientele. Maybe you're getting more subscribers, or maybe, you're getting recognition at your place of work where you're going to be able to see that you're going to be able to receive something wonderful, succeeding in ways you never thought you could. And it's all about abundance and success when we get this Sun card. Beautiful, beautiful card. Now, coming in with your heart message here, on a heart and emotional level, you've got be bold and strong. Look within. You will find everything you need there. Burst forth from your cocoon and fly. The sky is the limit if you follow your heart and your own inner guidance. Listen to what others say, but do not blindly follow their advice. Wow. Did I not talk about that? Shining your light, going out there, showcasing yourself here, not allowing, okay, listen to this, following blindly someone else's advice, right? So this is about you stepping up here, being independent, going for what it is you want, letting go of that energy that could have been holding you back. And then to get this beautiful message here that you need to fly, step out of your cocoon, you go independently, you stand in your confidence, and you go after what you deserve and want, and you're going to receive it. Wow, beautiful. And again, defending yourself, not backing down. Nine of Wands is all about that. You know, holding on to something that you've created, and you're not going to relinquish it and let go of it. Okay, this is about you not allowing somebody to come in here and try to take something away from you and ride on your coattails of success. Not going to happen. Aquarius, you're standing your ground. You're going forward. You're on your own personal journey independently now, and you are standing strong. Knight of Cups. Could be somebody coming in on an emotional level where the puzzle pieces fit. They could be offering you their hand in time, effort, support, and maybe even love. This could be a great romance. When this Knight of Cups comes charging in, he often takes you unawares, and it's almost like you've been swept off your feet or feel as though you've been rescued at that perfect moment you needed it. So this could be a water sign, either in business or in love, that comes in to do that. Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio, that could be coming towards you to assist you, to help you, to be in your end of the ring to support you. Could be falling madly in love, my beautiful friends, or falling in love with a situation in your life. Or this could be a relationship that is going to the next level, or one that is healing and, you know, becoming even more secure. So it is about building a good foundation. It's about security. It's about weddings and proposals and maybe engagements. But if you're not the one that's getting involved in this personally, you might be having someone around you sending you an invitation and wanting to celebrate and invite you as a guest or be a participant in that situation. Now, coming in the final row, you've been given surrender to effortlessness. Well, this is very similar to letting go. Stop pushing so hard. The art of living means going with the flow instead of trying to force the river. So I think you're going to be stepping back, letting things go, going with the flow, not trying to go against resistance or force or push situations and issues around you. If they're not going as quick as you want them, that's okay. That there's a reason for that. So I do think that you're going to be able to, if you just don't allow yourself to get frustrated because of time and things not going as quickly as you want, I think you're going to be fine. So just go with the flow. Hey, you've got a lot of beautiful energy coming in this week. Embrace it. Enjoy it. Throw it back out into the universe so you get tenfold more. Coming in under that, you've got the Page of Cups. And the Page of Cups is usually about some young energy or some young and new and up and budding idea coming in towards you in the form of maybe a person or the energy or something coming in. I do believe that you may be thinking at this time that this if this person is coming towards you with their hand in affection or love, you may be saying, I don't think so, because they look younger, act younger, and may even be younger than you. Don't allow yourself to get caught up in the illusions in your head of what other people's opinions mean. They mean nothing, okay? This could be, you know, the start of a friendship or romance or the renewal of one from your past. Or this could be a current relationship that enters a new phase. But trust your intuition. I think you're tapping into your psychic abilities now, Aquarius, and you're going to be able to do great character analysis on this energy. You could be receiving something in the form of a beautiful love letter. Something could be coming to you this week in the form of that. Pay attention to your dreams, because I do believe that you're going to connect with somebody here. Some of you may be dealing with a youth or someone younger, okay, which you're going to be stepping up and maybe mentoring, helping, assisting. You care for them on an emotional level. The Knight of Swords, yeah, fast moving energy, charging in on his steed. You know, this is a card of caution. If there's anything coming in very quickly that does require you acting on it fast, make sure you're careful. You don't want to be charging in and make a mistake. This is also about not making impulsive decisions this week. Take your time. But this could also be your knight in shining armor that shows up for you as well. Just like our beautiful Knight of Cups. He's more emotional. But this one here is like your Archangel Michael. He comes in very strong and he makes a presence. But if you're in the In the form of having to step up very quickly because you hear notification about any legal documents or correspondence or contracts you need to sign, that's great. You've got to go and do it. But make sure you keep your eyes open and your head down and you read between the lines, or at least get representation and counsel that can guide you through that. Okay? This person that's coming in this night could be a go-getter. He's unstoppable, or her. And they're decisive. They're knowledgeable. They're tireless. They're assertive. But they can also be straightforward and very abrupt, this individual. So you could be dealing with an energy like that. They tend to be a little bit tactless because they're so powerful. They bowl you over. So keep your eyes open for that this week. Well, my beautiful Aquarius, this is your reading for this week. And I think it's very interesting. I do think you're making headway here. You're making some success coming in as long as you stand in the power of your due diligence and determination. And, you know, remember, everything that glitters isn't gold. And don't be taken down the garden path by that snake charmer, okay, that could be coming your way. Be careful of that. And also, you know, just go with the flow and let things go. Don't get all uptight about things this week. And let go of the past. You know, throw that beautiful stardust out into the universe because you're a star and you deserve to shine like the sun. Well, I wish you a great remainder to today and a beautiful, optimistic week here to look forward to. And let's all continue to play safe, stay safe, and be safe. And know that I send you many blessings and much love. And I'll see you soon.